When I was about 6 years old, my mom once told me, "Be careful, baby, when you eat that watermelon, because if you eat the seeds, a watermelon will grow in your tummy." So, you have to know one thing. My mom was only joking because her friends were there. But, of course, I didn't know that. I was only 6 years old. Unfortunately, it was a really hot day, and I was so hungry and thirsty, and the watermelon looked so red and juicy that I just ate the whole thing, seeds included. I didn't care about what my mom said because my thirst and hunger went away. That piece of information got hidden somewhere in my brain and didn't come out until that night my good old friend came and visited me. Fear. So you have to know one thing about this guy. He is a stalker. He keeps showing up at places where I'm at. At the doctor's office just before a flu shot, or at my classroom door just before a history test, or when I'm in bed. Yeah, he just snuggles up under the blanket and starts whispering, "Hey, so I heard some really creepy noises coming from your closet. I think you should go check." Since my first encounter with this intrusive guy, I have felt scared multiple times, and I didn't like it. My whole life, I have been wondering what are some things that we can do in order to feel less scared. So I decided to look into it. So, first of all, what is fear? Fear is one of the basic human emotions, and it almost works like an instinct. This unpleasant feeling is provoked when we sense danger or when we feel unsafe. One might say, "Ugh, I wish I could be fearless. My life would be much easier." Actually, fear helps us protect ourselves. It makes us alert to danger and prepares us to deal with it. Fear is one thing, but what if you suffer from a phobia? When a person has a phobia, the fear is out of proportion compared to the potential danger. But for that person, the danger fear is real because the fear can be so intense. Also, according to Kids Health, which is a famous website that provides tools to make the best health choices for kids, a phobia causes a person to avoid a thing or situation that makes them feel scared because the physical sensation can be so strong. Okay, but how does fear work in the body? When we sense danger, our brain sends some signals to the nervous system causing it to activate. This provokes some unpleasant reactions such as faster heartbeat, rapid breathing, and high blood pressure. The blood pumps into your muscles and prepares your body for action, fighting or running. This reaction is called fight or flight because your body is preparing for exactly that, either fight off the danger or run away as fast as you can. Another element that we have to consider when feeling scared is the amygdala, a small structure in our brain that keeps track of certain experiences that trigger strong emotions, such as happiness, sadness, but also fear. When a person encounters, or for some people just think about, a really scary thing, the amygdala turns on and sends some alert signals to the brain. Perfect! Now that we know what fear is and how it works in our body, let's take action. What are some things that we can do in order to feel less scared? According to the Mental Health Foundation, the best way to overcome a fear is to face it. Now, I'm not telling you to go up to a spider, pet it, and give it kisses. In this case, I'm talking about overcoming certain fears of situations, like going on a roller coaster. Maybe it turns out that the Twisted Colossus at Six Flags Magic Mountain, California isn't as scary as you thought. Another thing that we can do to overcome a fear is to exercise. Now, I know what you may be thinking, "Oh, I'm feeling so scared that I could die and you're telling me to exercise?" Yes. Exercising requires concentration and it will take your mind off your fear. If you don't like exercising, like I know many of you don't, then you can just relax. Read a book, listen to some music, do some yoga. And if you're paralyzed in bed under your sheets because you think that there's a monster under your bed ready to jump up and eat you, then you can just think of something you really like or a really relaxing place. Several experts, though, say that there is a process in overcoming your fear. You can do this by gradually facing them. Now, be careful, because you have to be willing and brave enough to do it. And if you're not... I'm totally kidding. It's fine. You can just ask a friend or a parent that you know can guide you into the process to actually guide you. And if you think that nobody's experienced enough to do this, then you can just ask a therapist. What you have to do is create a list of your fears, from the one that scares you the least to the one that scares you the most. You're like dividing your fear in different categories and facing them step by step. For example, if you're scared of spiders, your first step could be looking at a picture of a spider. Then looking at a picture of those big hairy spiders that nobody likes, like tarantulas. Your last step could be, for example, finding yourself alone in a room with a spider that you have to catch and let out. Now, in this case, there are a lot of various tools that can help you easily catch bugs and animals, just like spiders. If you find yourself in one of these situations, then you can use one of those tools. So after I used some of the tips that I just told you, my good old friend disappeared, like for real. For example, I tried conquering my fear of, and now don't hate me, Star Wars. Now I know what you may be thinking. Oh, she's scared of Star Wars? What a wimp. I know. It's just that my younger self didn't know that, and my friends forced me to watch the episode in which there was the most blood. I was traumatized. But a couple of weeks ago, I tried watching Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and I couldn't have been more lucky. Master Yoda actually talks about fear. He says, "Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger, anger leads to hate, and hate leads to suffering." So you see, do not succumb to your fears, use my tips. Thank you so much for watching and have a great fearless life.